Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I will explain about open board software for online teaching. So means where it is available and what are the operating systems are supported for this software and how it works. So all these things I will explain in this session. Okay, so first you type open board in Google search. Okay, open board, right? So you will get this page. Okay, first you click on download open board. Okay, so you will direct it to this page. Okay, so here so this is Mac operating system. So this is for Windows and this is for Ubuntu. Okay, Ubuntu 64 bits. Okay, and Windows 7 plus. Okay, so for Mac below 10.14 you can download from here, and above 10.14, that means latest version 10.15, so for those operating systems you can download the open board software from this icon. Okay, and so these are the three operating systems which are supported this open board software for online teaching. Okay, and next, so just you can download by clicking on this icons. Okay, so already I downloaded in my laptop. Okay, so installation process also very simple. Okay, wait a minute. Okay, so I will minimize this page. So now I move on to download section. So this is open board software icon. Okay, after completion of installation, so you will get the icon like this. Okay, yes. So I will click on this open board software. Okay, you will get this page like this. Okay, so we have two things here. One is vertical toolbar, another one is horizontal toolbar. Okay, so from this vertical toolbar, so you will get some options like a pen, eraser, marker, indicator. Okay, and zoom in, zoom out, okay, laser pointer projection and lines, and text editor, and capture the part of the screen, and the virtual keyboard. Okay, like that we have some options, and you can place this vertical toolbar from left side, otherwise you can place right side also. This you can drag and you can place wherever you want. Okay, and so this is pen. Okay, you will by selecting this pen you can write anything on this whiteboard. Okay, so like this. Okay, so this is marker. Okay, you can take marker and you can write anything. Okay, and next, this is eraser, so you can erase anything. And for example, here I am writing, you want to maximize this one, so you can use maximization button. Okay, and if you want to minimize this one, so you can minimize also. And if you take a line, so you will get lines like this. Okay. Okay, and this is the text editor, so by clicking on this text editor button, so you can write anything on this. Okay, and if you want to paste same thing on this screen, so add to current page, then you will get like this. Okay, so this is virtual keyboard. Okay, so by using this keyboard also you can enter the information on this particular screen. Okay, so and next, so if you want to erase complete thing, just you can erase this button. Just you click on this button, so entire screen will be remove the data. And so, and one more thing, once you observe here, so here we have colors. So for example, this is marker. I can select the marker, sorry, I can select the pen, and you can click on this blue button, then you will get the blue ink. Okay, and if you click on this one, so you will get, and you can click on red, you will get like this. Okay, so, and if you want to change the thickness of the pen also, and you can select this first button. Okay, so you will get like this. Okay, if you get second button, then you will get thickness of the pen is like this. And if you click on third one, so the thickness of the pen is like this. Okay, and this, in the same way, eraser also, the first button you will get like this. Okay, and second button, so you will get like this. Third, like that means increasing the eraser size. Okay, by clicking on these three buttons related to eraser, these three buttons are related to pen and marker. Okay, and this is undo, redo, and pages. Okay, if you complete this page, you have to move on to next page, then you click on this plus button, you will get the second page. Okay, so like that, if you complete 3 or 4 pages, then you have to move a previous one, and you have to move on next page by clicking on these two buttons, right? Erase means the complete page will be remove the data by clicking on this erase button. Okay, so, and this is okay, and next, so by clicking on this web, so you can browse anything on Google. And this documents, once we are moving to this document section. Okay, so here we have so this is my document section. So whatever the thing you have to finish on this particular screen, that automatically saved, that will be appear in this my document section. So this is 8/9/2020, 5:09 p.m. I'm creating certain document that stored here. Okay, and you don't want to save particularly. Okay, so automatically it saves the entire data whatever you are using on this particular page, right? So you can collect the that particular data from this my document section here. So this is my document section. So from that you can collect your document. And if you want to export the file, so you can go for this icon. So here, export to PDF and export to OpenBoard format. So by using this button, so you have to export your document in whatever the format you want. Okay, and import, if you want to pick the PDF file from your desktop, so you can use this icon. Okay, and if you want to add images to your explanation, screen, so you can use this add button. Okay, you can click on this add images. You can click on add images. Just you can pick the image from your desktop, and you can open here. Then, so you will get the page, you will get the image like this. So you will get the image like this. After that, you can edit anything. You can edit anything on this particular page, and if you explain this image also. Okay, so this is regarding adding images to your screen. And next, when, so after that, this is document section. Okay, so add imaging, for adding images, you have to click on this add button. And if you want to add the documents like PDF files, so you have to go through this import button. Okay, and next, you have to create new folders and new documents by clicking on this particular thing. I think this is my document section. If you want new document, just you can go for this plus button, and if you want new folder also you can go through this particular button. And next, this is document section. Okay, after that you have to go for and this open board software, we don't have any minimization object on this particular screen, so you cannot, once you open this software you cannot minimize this one. Okay, so in that case, if you want to do any simultaneous operation with your laptop, okay, so in that situation you have to click on this show desktop, then you will go to your desktop section. Okay, we don't have any minimization section on that open board software. If you want to move on to your desktop or any other folder if you require, so you can click on show desktop section. If you want to again open board software, you can click on this particular button. So if you want to move on your desktop, just you click on this show desktop. Okay, if you want again you have to move on to open board software, you can click on this one, right? So next one, this is open board settings. Okay, these all options are not at all required, so you can go to preferences. Okay, once you click on the preferences, you can direct it to this page. Okay, and you can observe here, so display settings and grid settings, pen settings, marker settings, network licenses, credits and above. Okay, these things are not required from networks to above, so just you focus on these four things. First, display. So you can adjust the display whatever you want. Okay, so here this toolbar is vertical. If you want a horizontal, you click on horizontal. Okay, then you will get a horizontal section like this, right? And if you want again vertical, you can select on vertical section. And here the toolbar is available in the bottom section. If you want top, then you can you can choose the option positioned at the top. Okay, you can place this one the toolbar can be shifted to top. Okay, if you want to bottom, then you can select this one. Okay, and here we have certain keyboard, virtual keyboard. In that if you want to use this virtual keyboard, you can click on this virtual keyboard button and select the button size 29x29 and 41x41. Okay, yes, you can. This is not required. Okay, and the mode to start in is a board. Okay, we have board and desktop. You can pick any one, no problem. And empty trash for documents older than 30 days. You can 30, 60, whatever you want, you can put it here. Okay, these are the display settings. Just only two settings. One is this vertical bar, vertical toolbar, and this is the bottom top bar. You can place this according to you. Okay, so and next when comes to grid. Okay, so here we only two things, that is opacity. Yes, you can fix this opacity medium level, otherwise high level, not at all problem. And next one comes to pen. So here we have some colors, so you can change these colors also. Okay, and this is line width. Okay, this you can observe here. So this line width, so fine is nothing but this is line section, right? So fine is nothing but the first button. The second medium button is the second one is a medium button. The third button is related to strong button. If you change this fine button knob, okay, it will be increases, right? So that will affect this line. Okay, the first button, right? So this is complete. This fine button completely related to first button, and the medium button completely related to second, and strong button is completely related to third. So whatever the thickness you require, you can choose from this settings, right? And in the next one, show preview circle from, yes, you can put it as 20. Don't choose this, pen is pressure sensitive. Okay, so for this open board software, you have to use digital writing pad with the digital pen. Okay, so don't tick this pen is pressure sensitive while you are clicking on this option. So you have to use you have to apply pressure on your pen. Okay, so you don't click on this this option. Okay, just you can leave it. Okay, next we have to move on to marker. So this is marker related settings. Okay, and So this is regarding OpenBoot software and settings. Okay, so this is a very useful software for online teaching. Okay, if you want to write anything on this screen, okay, so instead of using whiteboard, just you can use this software, and the software access PDF files from your desktop as well as a web search also. Okay, and you have some three-dimensional 3D figures also we have, okay, that I will show here. So just you can observe here, so pictures, okay, and okay, so from this section you can select the animations and the 3D diagrams. Okay, those all things are available in this once you go through that particular section. Okay, so this is regarding OpenBoot software. Okay, so this is very very useful for online teaching. Okay, and if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and share this information to your friends. Okay, thank you.